Hi everybody, to the third video of the series of designing non-circular convex gears. In this video we are going to apply the proposed methodology on elliptical gears second order, rotating about the geometrical center of the ellipse centrode or beach curve. Also we will see the resulted outputs of the Matlab code software and use them to generate the 3D model on SOLIDWORKS. Then we will check the cut gears to test the meshing on the test rig practically. As we know, elliptical gears are special case. Elliptical gears are identical in terms of the centrode or the pitch curve. These centrodes really can be described by equations as x equals to the major axis multiplied by cosine theta and y equals to the semi-minor axis multiplied by sine theta. By the way, theta is the rotating angle of the first gear. Anyway, the center distance in this case is the summation of the semi-major and semi-minor axes of the ellipses or the centrodes. The speed ratio of the elliptical gears has two lobes, meaning there are two increments and two decrements in the speed ratio. Let's see the Matlab code software of this type of non-circular gears. First of all, we need to enter the needed inputs for the design: semi-major and semi-minor axes, A and P, which are essential for designing the centrodes. Then the module, M, and the Brugger angle, Phi, are essential for designing the teeth profiles. The Matlab code software will correct the inputs and calculate the number of teeth, which must be integer, of course. So if the number of teeth was not integer by 1 over 1000 variance, the code software will correct the value of P, the semi-minor axis, to get the integer number of teeth on the centrode. Then the base, tip, and throat curves will be calculated, as well as the evolute of the ellipse. The second step will be generation of the teeth profiles for each tooth as explained in the previous video, and save the coordinates into text file. Thus, we can import the coordinates of each tooth into SOLIDWORKS program and generate the 3D model of each gear of the gear set. Here we can assemble the gear set and test the meshing in the meshing study in SOLIDWORKS program. Really, the theoretical study will not be enough to say that those gears are okay. So we cut the gears by laser in 5 mm thickness and test the meshing visually on the test rig. We can note the meshing between the teeth of both gears here, as well as the measured practical speed ratio on the laptop screen. Please write your opinions and queries in the comments if you have any.